Hello CSPro users, and welcome to CSPro Video Tutorial 4, Enter Data. In this tutorial, we will enter data using the CSPro Data Entry application created in Tutorial 3. The questionnaire we will be using is the same one used in Tutorials 1, 2, and 3. If you do not have CSPro already running, open CSPro. Navigate to the CSPro Tutorial 3 Data Entry application. My entry in the My CSPro Tutorial folder. Open the My Entry application by double-clicking on myentry.ent. Run CSEntry by clicking on the traffic light on the toolbar or by pressing Ctrl-R. CSPro will ask you to select a data file. The data we key will go into this file. I will keep the data in the My CSPro Tutorial folder and place it in a file named tutorial.dat. I click on Open. Since the file does not yet exist, CSPro asks me if I want to create the file. I will click on Yes. Now I can enter an operator ID. This identifies the operator entering the data. I can put anything I want here, and I will simply put A, B, C, and click OK. Now I am ready to enter data. We will type in the data for our first case or questionnaire using a fictitious family of four. Type 1, then enter to fill in the household ID. Type 48 in the age field. The cursor will now move to the sex field. Type 3 in the sex field. CSEntry will tell you this value is out of range because it is not in the value set in the data dictionary. With the out of range message still showing, type 1. The message will go away and the cursor will move to the marital status field. Continue typing in data for the rest of the family as shown here. Here are some tips. You can move backward to the previous field using Shift Tab, left arrow, or up arrow. You can move forward to the next field using Enter, Tab, right arrow, or down arrow. You can change a field by simply going to the field and typing a new number into it. You can erase a field by pressing the space bar. We will now tell the roster we have finished entering people for this household. Click on Navigation. Click on End Group or press Control Slash. CSPro now takes you to the first field of the housing record. Type 1 in the Type Household field. Type 1 in the Type Roof field. CSPro will ask, accept this case. At this point, you can select No and go back to make changes to the data. If you are satisfied the data are correct, press Enter or click on Yes. CSPro is now ready to accept data for the next questionnaire. With the cursor ready, to enter the next household ID. We will now stop adding cases. Click on the Stop button on the toolbar, or press Escape or Control S, or select Mode Stop from the main menu. When you have completed this step, you will see this screen. We will now modify the case. We realize that the first person in the household is really 45 years old and not 48 as we typed in. We will go back into the data and change this value. To do this, we will go into Modify Mode. You can select Modify Mode from the menu, or press Control M, or click on the Modify icon on the toolbar. You should see the first form with a value 1 showing for the ID item. Click on age 48 of the person's form. Type 45 into the age field. Press F12 to indicate you have finished making your changes. CS Entry will ask you to accept the case. Click Yes. CSPro will save your changes and exit from Modify Mode. Close CS Entry by clicking on the X in the top right corner or selecting File, Exit from the main menu. We now have completed doing data entry in CSPro. Before going to the next tutorial, take some time to practice using CS Entry. Make up some fictitious households and enter data maybe for about 10 to 20 households so you become accustomed to the CS Entry program.